How do we engage with the disparate group of people who occupy the space of the inner city? How do we engage, for example, with those who live in the relative seclusion of their high-rise residential apartments? How do we engage with the various levels of civic leadership, those involved in government at the various levels across our country? How do we engage with the poor and marginalised who so typically gravitate toward the heart of the city and yet so often seem almost unseen and unheard of? How do we engage with the inner city workers, those who live out in the suburbs and yet commute into the city day by day and at the end of the day go back home to the relative comfort of their suburban homes? What about the nightclub set who come in around about 10 o'clock of an evening and stay through till 3 and 4 in the morning? How do we engage with those kinds of people? I suddenly found that I needed to seriously recalibrate how I saw ministry in the urban context. And yet as I've studied the scriptures, I've become increasingly convinced that the God of the Bible is a God who has a passionate heart of concern for the city. Why does God have such a heart of concern? Well, the city is a place, of course, of great need. It's a place of concentrated need in so many ways, and yet it's also a place of extraordinary opportunities. As we look at the city, we see a place of incredible influence where society is shaped and fashioned. Indeed, we might properly say, as goes the city, so goes the nation. And so I want to encourage you to contemplate the possibility of studying with us here at Malian Theological College in Semester 2, as together we look at the challenges and the opportunities that come with ministry in the urban context.